that only now we are facing technologies which can have a major impact on our life. Our generations have been going through that. So that is that has been part of our life. But there are, in my mind, two significant ways in which the modern changes are different than what we have ever seen. One major impact is that the new technology is becoming very personal in nature. You know, the mobile phone that I carry is virtually almost part of my personality. You know, your mobile phone and its usage has become, it affects you virtually all your living time. So it has become very, very personal. The only other two things that I can think of which have become so personal are maybe my wristwatch and my specs. Otherwise, everything else is something which I can choose to engage, choose not to engage, move away from. But the phone and the way it impacts is almost becoming that you become socially incapable of functioning, you know, unless the phone is there. So this technology is impacting your day-to-day ways of living. It's having an impact on your thinking and on your ways of interacting, social behavior. It is getting introjected into your day-to-day life. So that is one major difference than other changes that take place. Another major change that has happened is that the time from innovation to getting widely adopted has been collapsing at a very, very fast pace. You know, even when I was passing out from my college and computers were the something which was coming new, in fact, there's a new thing that was coming up, still the gap between the moment it will become first time available to widely available would be in decades, maybe 10 years, 15 years, that was the gap, 20 years, when it will become. In fact, the difference between a technology becoming available in America to India itself was about 5 years. Nowadays, from the moment technology becomes available to its adoption, you measure time in months. So this fast pace is another major thing that we are seeing. Now this combination of technology which is impacting individuals and their interpersonal relationships and the pace is a very, to my mind, a dangerous mix. Why is it dangerous? Because number one, you have a technology which through which young people have new ways of interacting with each other. There are new ways you find friends, there are new ways you form groups, there are new ways you interact with strangers. These are not the ways which were there before. Previously, it has been the job of teachers and parents to teach children how do you behave in society, how do you meet and interact with strangers, how do you interact with your elders, how do you behave in a group. There's, you know, there's a whole process of culturization in schools and teaching and what are the do's and don'ts and what are the dangers. That happens. But with this thing, children are discovering different ways of forming groups, meeting with strangers, interacting, and parents don't even know how it operates, forget trying to teach them. And therefore, we are seeing a new generation coming up with tools to interact with each other without having the benefit of learning from a previous generation on what are the good ways and bad ways, what are the etiquettes, what are the dangers of doing. And I think that is something of whose risk we still haven't really fully realized. Think of Hillary Clinton. Hillary lost election because she did not know really what care to take while using emails, etiquettes of emails. That was the cost she had to pay. And how to use Twitter became the major strength of Donald Trump. So it was really the social media which affected these major results. And as people are talking of, this may be the first president whose presidency might collapse because his use or misuse of Twitter. So imagine the kind of power that social media, our inability to understand the impact of social media in our interpersonal relationships is leading to kind of implications which we can't even imagine. I was trying to think of in why is it so difficult to get into that. And I find that there are social media, the way we use, creates certain illusions and break away from our old ways of doing things. First, in my mind, it creates an illusion of privacy when actually there is no privacy. You know, you can be sitting in your bedroom and tweeting or writing something on your, or putting on WhatsApp, or sitting even on loop on this thing, and you are absolutely with yourself. Those are the most intimate personal moments, and yet within seconds what you write could be broadcast all over the world. So what is the line between personal and intimate, and what is absolutely public? This is very difficult to understand. And forget adults, and if Donald Trump can't understand, how do you expect a youngster to understand and appreciate? You know, I'm a grandfather of four little grandchildren who are experts on social media, and I many times feel scared. What are they doing right now, and where are they going? Because their parents are in no position to really provide them full guidance on how do you get into that. So, to me, I think this is one of the major things, that this illusion it causes, not knowing the impact that you're having. Another thing is when you interact with people personally, there's lots of feedback through expression, through eyes. There are lots of moments, there are lots of opportunities to correcting yourself, saying sorry and saying something else. But when you interact through social media, every word you say becomes a word written in stone. It cannot be taken back. You know, what is the implication of that? It gets recorded and it's become these are the things which are look little, but I think have got implications which we still don't understand. To my mind, probably when academicians think of adopting social media in their education, which they must, and it can have lots of powerful impact, and I absolutely agree with you, sir, that it has to complement, it cannot replace, it has to complement the way teaching takes place, because teaching itself is a social activity. Teaching is also is learning from each other, teaching is also learning from many outer resources. There's so many things, and where social media can really become a major strength for that. But I think one of the major role teachers today must play is trying to teach children on new etiquettes of interaction. And unfortunately, it's not simply your nursery or school teachers who have to do that, because things are changing so fast that what our children are learning in school right now may be of no use when they reach college. To my mind, this is something which has to be repeated again and again during this thing. So I would like to therefore submit that apart from what all is going to be talked here on ways of using social media in education, care and use of social media for social and interaction and interpersonal relations, becoming aware of that is a very important role that teachers must play. I would like to actually stop over there, because I don't want to dilute that, and to my mind this is something which is becoming a major issue, and if we don't tackle, the new generation may not really know, may feel lost with the new impact of new technology coming. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.